For the lumbar spine, let's begin with this model of two lumbar vertebra, and we'll look at the posterior anatomy first. So you can see the posterior elements. All of you know this is the superior facet, this is the inferior facet, that would be the lamina. This is the transverse process. So what connects the superior facet with the inferior facet, the region is called the pars. This region, the connection between the superior and inferior facet, is called the pars interarticularis. The reason why it is called interarticularis is because it is between two articular facets. That's why interarticularis, and pars is Latin for part. So this region of the bone is quite important structurally for the spine surgical anatomy, because it is something that you look out for from whenever you are doing a posterior approach. So the true pars is this region. This is called the true pars. Okay, so the part which connects the superior facet with the inferior facet. What we do see is during surgery is what we call the lateral pars. So lateral pars is this region is called the lateral pars. So the reason why there is a distinction like this between the two is that whenever you are doing a laminectomy like this, you want to keep some bone intact in this region. Because if your laminectomy is very wide, let's say this wide, then this bone thins out quite a bit. And if you thin out this pars to less than say 5 millimeters, when the patient mobilizes, it can fully fracture through and cause a iatrogenic lysis. So that's the reason why you want to see this region carefully when you are doing a posterior approach. And this border is very clearly visible during the surgery, and that is what is called as the lateral pars. Right, and you want to keep this area preserved whenever you are doing a laminectomy. Now the other thing of the pars region is seen in the oblique view. If I do this a little oblique way, this true pars, you can see a fracture or a stress fracture of this on an oblique x-ray. And then on oblique x-ray, it looks like a Scotty dog. If you Google Scotty dog, you'll understand what a Scotty dog looks like. It's a breed of a dog which has like a squarish mouth. So this would be the mouth. The pedicle looks like the eye of the dog. The superior facet is the ear. This is the snout, right? The inferior facet is the front leg. This lamina becomes the body of the dog, right? And the neck of the dog is the pars. So the neck is the pars. So if you have a spondylolysis or a break in the pars, then the dog looks as if the dog is beheaded, because it looks separate. The head looks separate from the body. So a beheaded dog or a dog with a collar is what a spondylolysis will look like, right? So let's look at how it looks on the x-ray. Transverse process, the eye is the pedicle, and this is where the beheading occurs. That's the pars. So on the x-ray, it will look like this. So you may be asked to tell what are all these different parts. So this is the ear of the dog, is the superior facet. The leg is the inferior facet. The body is the lamina. The lower leg is the inferior facet on the opposite side, you know, and this becomes the tail of the dog. On the opposite side, superior facet is the tail of the dog, right? So this is what is called as the Scotty dog, or an oblique view of the lumbar spine, used for diagnosis of spondylolysis.